Ένα ιάσκιο. Είχε physical body. But occasionally, when you feel bad, then your physical body feels as well bad, feels awful. You may drag your feet because you feel bad physically, and you don't know why. Now, that by itself implies that what we feel, our own emotions, acts on our physical body and transform it to something that behaves differently than what it does usually. You may be healthy, but if you don't feel well, you drag your feet. What has happened there? I will stay just to the question, but I will insist on the fact that emotions are energy. And they are energy because they act on our physical body and transform it. You see the line of thinking. Okay? So then, we just identified a component of our existence, a different body that it is ours, but it is not, cannot be seen by our, cannot be distinguished by our senses, which is known as emotional or astral body, which actually affects us. Now, this astral body has shape. It's very much like us. As a matter of fact, it is physical. I will call it, just to help us distinguish between the physical and the astral body, I will call it near physical, because it has shape, and because provided somebody has the capability to sense the corresponding frequency and density, you can touch it and you can live with this body. Okay? So it is near physical. It definitely has shape, although we have also to understand that it is served by different physical laws. It has its own set of laws. Then what we did so far, we identify another component of us, another body known as emotional or astral body, which is also composed of energy, but not sensory energy, it is subtle energy, and this subtle energy affects the physical body. Did we finish? No. Because just above that, there is another body, there is the mental body. And the mental body does not have shape. This is actually the type of subtle energy where, on the basis of which, nothing can happen. Nothing can happen until somebody thinks of it. Nothing will happen until somebody specify what is supposed to happen. And all of these specifications, all of this capability of creation, because that's what it is concentrated in this energy level, which is subtle. It is of higher frequency and less density, but nevertheless it is subtle energy and affects everything. Why? Depending on what you are thinking, your feelings are changing, and depending on your feelings, your physical body is changing. Therefore, we are talking about energy. Following that, we have the spiritual body. Now, the spiritual body is where everything starts and everything eventually returns. Okay? This is where the spiritual force emanates. This is where our own soul belongs to. This is where everything is empowered and sustained throughout all its creational cycle. So the spiritual component, the spiritual body, is of utmost importance for the reasons of, first of all, allowing us the existence we have and sustaining our own development. So it's of the utmost importance. And this model is what is known as four existential body model. It's a purely existential model on the basis of which you can see ourselves in four different facets: as a spiritual body, as a mental body, as an emotional or astral body, and as a physical body. There is a lot more to be said. I think I would just carry on, because it's a rare opportunity to put everything in a small segment and have the give the opportunity to everybody to be able to appreciate it. There is a bidirectional relationship from body to body to body to body. And this relationship is very well known. We can name it. For example, from the spiritual body to the mental body, we have the soul. This is where our soul is. Soul is the component of the spiritual body which is devoted to us. Then, the relationship between the mental body and the emotional body is a thought. Somebody has to think something, there is a thought that is passing through that results into emotions. And emotion is the connection between the emotional or astral body and the physical body, the all-powerful emotion. It's very important to remember that both the physical and the emotional body are physical, which means we are coming here at this particular level where we're materializing, where our physicality exists. But that means nothing, because there are other creations which are materializing on the emotional component or the astral body, and they are as real as we are. However, in our case, we have been blessed in a way to live in an environment where our physicality is doubled in a slow-moving environment, which help us to appreciate more our experiences. This is why in metaphysics they say that many entities are fighting to have an opportunity to materialize into this physical world because of the beauty of it. Because it's very slow and allow us to see things and appreciate things. Needless to say, not everybody does that. As a matter of fact, very few do that. That's why we don't learn as fast. Anyway, so it is important to keep in mind that both these layers have materializations. But these materializations are done on the basis of thought processes, mental processes, specifications defined in the mental body under the direct influence of the spiritual body. You should also remember that, from our point of view, our physicality is nothing more than the cause, is the result. Everything that happens, it happens above this horizontal line. This is where the causal planes exist. And it is the cooperation of these causal planes that result into the physical changes, the transformations that we recognize because of our limited senses. Very important concepts to keep in mind. A last thought is the following. We are not only physical body, not only emotional body, not only mental body or spiritual body. We are all four. And all four are in very close, very well knit, seamless cooperation, independently of space and time. This is very important to be understood metaphysically. And I recognize the difficulty because it's quite abstract. That means you are looking at me and you can distinguish a physical body. But my soul is here. It's here. My thinking level, my mental body is here. My emotional body is here. Everything is here, but we cannot see it with our eyes. Okay? This is why I have all of this, this principle, I stress this principle by this auric field that unites everything. And I can remind you that in the cases of the phenomenon of extrasensory perception known as aura, when we are distinguishing certain frequencies that cover the full body, they are nothing more than elements of the emotional body that somehow, through specific processes, we are able to depict into a single picture. Okay? So the aura is nothing more than components, not the whole thing, of the emotional body, and possibly certain elements of the other bodies that through technical means we are able to capture and describe in through utilization of photographic principles. Okay? This is why you will recall the term auric field being also used extensively in the aura photography. Because the aura photography is a rough representation of this egg-like structure. Hmm? So this is the four existential body model. And I'm closing my brief discussion of that by reminding us that that doesn't relate only to human, but for every single creation example. Each and everyone has the same elements, but each and everyone has also its own unique representation and its own unique limitations. Which means that when you are talking about a subatomic particle, it does have a physical body, it does have emotional body, it does have mental body, it does have spirit, but don't expect to see it. Okay? It is there though. And given the time when our measuring apparatus increases to the extent that we are capable of capturing details, then I will sound more scientific than now.